Maybe she's retaining a magnetic charge. Or maybe it's Maybelline. Salutations, friends. My name is Brianna Bond, otherwise known as No Ordinary Scholar, and I am part of that dying breed of people that is still adding movies to their DVD collection. And one movie that we recently got that I'd actually never seen before was Be Kind Rewind. Starring, and let me look at my notes, Jack Black as Jerry, Mostef as Mike, Danny Glover as Mr. Fletcher, and Melanie Diaz as Alma. So Mike works at Mr. Fletcher's VHS-only video store, Be Kind Rewind. One day, Jerry breaks into the town's power plant, gets his ass electrocuted, and then he goes into the shop, and his body seems to have erased all of the tapes. So Jerry, Mike, and Alma work to put some rush, well, not necessarily rush, but they work to put together some shorter versions of these movies, just remake them with basically no budget. Remake these movies, shorter versions, so that way Mr. Fletcher and Be Kind Rewind can stay exactly where they are and make sure they don't get shut down. I'm gonna leave the summary of this right there because you really should watch the movie for yourself. It's a good movie. But it does leave us with two pretty big questions. One, do they save the video store? And two, can this actually happen? So the movie seems to allude that Jerry's body becomes magnetized when he is electrocuted. So if we're gonna get to the bottom of this, we need to know how tapes can be erased. How does one erase a VHS? If there's anybody left that doesn't know the answer to this, I'm here to fill you in. But you honestly see it depicted in media quite a bit. You even see it in the more recent movie, Knives Out, which, side note, asshole Chris Evans is the best Chris Evans. Fight me. But the answer is magnets. This happens because the actual media and the data that is stored on the VHS tape is arranged magnetically. So when you play a tape, you are experiencing, and this could be a quote from a Mr. Justin Pott here, an interpretation of the arrangement of electromagnetic particles. When you have a magnet near a tape, you're completely rearranging all of that data, and you don't need like some lab's super magnet to do this. The common kitchen refrigerator magnet is plenty strong, and that alone would be able to erase that one random tape everyone's parents took of them bathing for some reason. Then our next inquiry is just how do magnets work? And according to National Geographic, the movement of electrons around their nucleus, quote, generates an electric current and causes each electron to act like a microscopic magnet. When we talk about an item's magnetism, if most of the electrons are moving in the same direction, then the item's going to have magnetism. But if equal numbers are moving in opposite directions, then the magnetism is canceled out. How does something become magnetic? That's gonna be another quote. To become magnetized, another strongly magnetic substance must insert that blah. I can't read. I can write a book, but I can't read. Not my strong suit. Try it again. To become magnetized, another strongly magnetic substance must enter the magnetic field of an existing magnet. But the mechanics of magnetism are really where this whole thing starts to break down. The movie is attempting to say that Jerry gains this long-term magnetism when he is electrocuted, but not only are humans not capable of maintaining a magnetic charge, any magnetic charge created from electricity is lost when the source of electricity is gone. And the first of these reasons really helps to explain why we don't have little magnetos running around because they went into an MRI machine. Now, all may seem lost, but there's still one avenue we can try and go down. So after Jerry gets electrocuted, he's walking down the street, and all of these pieces of aluminum foil start sticking to him, which is weird because aluminum isn't magnetic. So it made me start to think, and it made me remember back being a kid, dragging my feet against some carpet and sticking a balloon to my face. So that made me think static electricity. But according to Wikipedia, because we respect Wikipedia's fact checking here, static electricity can only be achieved through friction. And even if somehow Jerry was able to maintain an electrical charge after being electrocuted, which factually, again, just couldn't happen, but even if he could, according to an experiment done by Sidney B. Geller, where he put magnetic media against a ton of crazy obstacles, from like magnets, of course, to electrocution, to nuclear radiation, and even heat, and a couple more, the only thing that can erase a tape, that can erase magnetic media without leaving physical signs of damage, is another magnet. So you know what that means? We just found the star of the MCU's Phase 4. Cause you know, Iron Man ain't got none compared to Jerry. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw here, there are many other ways you can support me. You can go subscribe to my blog channel. Over there, we actually did end up moving the book live streams that I do on YouTube. We moved those to that channel, as well as a bunch of fun other things. You can purchase my book, The Queen of Thieves, A New Throne, available on Amazon.com. Go down to the links in the description. You'll find a link to my website, noordinaryscholar.com, and that has a full master list of other things. But most importantly, we cannot forget about the Patreon squad. Over there, you get so many cool just freebies and stuff. You get the first chapters of my books early. You get to see the covers of my books early. You get even these videos a week ahead of time. We have a lot of fun over there, and if that sounds interesting to you, again, check out the links down below. But until next time, valedictions, friends.